Hey, what's up, y'all? Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you some of the products that I have been loving in the month of July. I can't believe August is here already. My birthday is a month away, which I'm trying not to freak out about. You know what I mean? But yes, don't come for my hair. She needs help. But yes, so if you want to see some of the products that I've been loving in the month of July, please keep watching. All right, you guys, to get started, my first monthly favorite is this bad boy right here. This is what you call a vampiro, or as I've learned recently, a mangonada. So I'm not sure if this is a Mexican-American delicacy or a Mexican delicacy, but it is mango ice cream with this chimoy, which is like a chili sauce, kind of like a syrup, and then like a little bit of the spice. This is so bomb, guys. Like, if you like mango, if you like little spicy sweet stuff, this is so freaking good. Definitely my monthly favorite. Okay, now to jump into the makeup and hair and skincare and stuff. I don't have a lot for you this month. July just flew by. Like, it flew by like in a blink of an eye. I didn't even like, yeah. I mean, it's weird too, because it went by so fast, but it also feels long if I think about it, because like the 4th of July and stuff like that. But yeah, so the first item that I want to talk to you guys about is Fix Plus. Okay. I've been a user of Fix Plus since my first year of college, which is about, well, I don't even want to say it out loud, but my freshman year of college, I grabbed one of these, and the associate at MAC was like, yeah, it's a setting spray and it's a primer spray, check it out, you know? And I was like, oh, this looks like water. Like, what the heck is this going to do for me? This has been something that I've constantly and constantly, constantly repurchased. This is specifically my monthly favorite, the Fix Plus Bronze Light. So it is like normal Fix Plus, where it melts in your makeup. It makes everything kind of morph into like one big, like kind of clay, like liquidy kind of. It basically, I feel like it takes like the molecules of the foundation and like kind of bridge, like mesh them together. That's what Fix Plus does normally. But then this Bronze Light one also gives you just the slightest bit of like kind of like soft bronzy sheen on your skin. It's not really chunky. It's not anything that you're gonna like visibly see like chunks and spots on your face. It just gives you a nice beautiful glow, and then it also gives you the amazing kind of like you know, effects of regular Fix Plus. So I absolutely love this, and I love a lot of the bronze summer collection that MAC Cosmetics had. And even though I wasn't able to kind of like experience it and like go into the stores and buy any of the stuff because of coronavirus, I still had to pick this up, and this is so, so beautiful. So I definitely recommend that. Okay, so my next favorite is another primer, and this is the Milk Hydro Grip, and this is the mini. This is the mini, so I literally am almost out of it, and I used it like maybe 4 times. So I would definitely recommend the big size, because you get more money for, or you get more product for your money. But I love this. It's not super, super hydrating. It definitely doesn't mattify you, but it definitely makes the foundation and your makeup like stick. It's like a sticker. It's like a sticker for all of your makeup. And I really, really love this. The texture is amazing. It doesn't feel too sticky, but it also doesn't feel like too liquidy. And it's like one of the only primers that I see actually do a difference for the longevity of my makeup. And this little guy, I believe, is like $15, and the big one is probably like $32 or $38. So I definitely recommend the big one more. So the smell of this is amazing, and I actually met the owner of Milk Makeup, because he's from my college town. So he came into our Sephora, and such a sweet man. So yeah, I love Milk just in general. But yeah, that is, sorry if I'm speaking too fast. I don't know if I'm speaking too fast. But I'm also trying not to make this video a million years long, you know what I mean? So anyway, next is the NARS Sheer Glow. I know that I recently put this in my previous video, but this is already like my most favorite foundation of this month because it is such a gorgeous foundation. It's the foundation that I'm wearing today, and it is just a beautiful medium to full coverage, but it's glowy. It is like, it's beautiful. The coverage is beautiful. It lasts all day on me. And I love NARS's color selection. It goes from super deep to super fair. I just think it's kind of funny that NARS doesn't believe in like pink undertones. So most of their foundations and concealers are neutral or yellow, which I personally works well for me. But yeah, I love NARS. My favorite way to apply this is with my fingers. If you want to see my previous video on how I applied it, I will try and link it somewhere around here. And yeah, or I'll link it in the description box, my previous video on how I actually applied this. But yeah, I think this foundation is so beautiful. I can see this working for drier skin, but as well as oily skin. As long as you set it, powder and other products like land perfect, or like work so well on top of this foundation. So I definitely recommend it. The only con I have is that it doesn't have a pump, but NARS does sell a pump for $6 that you can actually add to this. So yeah, I absolutely love this. We're going through these very fast, which I'm glad. Like I said, I don't need this video to be a million years old. My next monthly favorite is this Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. I haven't used this concealer since it first came out, and it was a concealer that I absolutely loved because it gave me the coverage that I liked. And even though I always get a color that's way too light for me, I think that it definitely works if I mix it in with like a darker concealer. But it is so full coverage, and it covers up all of my, you know, Chanel bags underneath my eyes. And just generally, it is a little too dry for me in the winter, but in the summer, I freaking love this concealer. Like, it just meshes so well with my natural oils and gives me a beautiful, like, kind of clear under eye, like, flawless under eye is what I'm trying to say. It is the concealer that I have on today. It does crease a little bit on me, but like everything creases on me. Like, there's not one concealer in this world that doesn't crease on me. The only thing that I can hope for is the least amount of creasing. And this, you know, doesn't give me horrible creases like I have seen in other, you know, concealers. But yeah, so I definitely recommend rediscovering this if you have let it go for a while. Okay guys, moving on. So one of my favorite this month has been this little shit right here. This is the e.l.f. Bite Size Eyeshadow Truffles. And this is in the shade, Bite Size Eyeshadow, and this is the palette called Truffles. This palette is so freaking cute. You can do so much with this. You can do a smoky eye. You can just do a neutral eye. You can do, you know, like the all over black smoky eye. You can do a touch of silver, you know what I mean? And the quality of these eyeshadows are so freaking good. And this was $3. They have multiple palettes of this like size, which is perfect for my kit because I do like, I am a traveling makeup artist and stuff like that. And at first I was like, you know what, let me just give it a try because it's $3, and you know, even if it, like, the eyeshadow sucked, like, I just wasted $3, you know, not a big deal, as opposed to buying an eyeshadow palette for $60 and it sucks, you know. So I actually used this on a photo shoot that I did with a bride, and it was so freaking pretty. It lasted throughout the entire shoot where it was hot as shit, you know what I mean? And so I absolutely have been loving this palette. I actually have this color right here in the crease, and then this one kind of like in the outer smudges. I did something just very simple and neutral today. So this palette is super versatile, and it's $3, guys. Like, super cute. And I think they have like a more warm toned one, a brights one. Like, this has been like kind of my go-to these four little eyeshadows go to for kind of like my lazy off days in July. I would definitely check these out. I know they sell at Walgreens, CVS, everywhere. So definitely recommend the Bite eyeshadow four pan thingy majigs. So yes, I absolutely love that. So the next thing that I want to share with you guys as my favorite are these little Fenty cream blushes. I know these blushes were a bit controversial just because of the size and the price. I do believe these are $20 and you get 3.0 grams or 0.10 ounces. But honestly, like I said in my review, I actually do have a video reviewing the Fenty blushes and I'll link it down below. I'm not mad at the price because with this product, it can definitely go a long way and you could use it as kind of like a cream eyeshadow as well because it does dry down. It's like a beautiful, beautiful satin color. It is a slight blush that I have on today. So my favorite, it's this color specifically, Rose Latte. This color is absolutely beautiful. It is like a nude pinkish color that works for me when I am super fair, but also works for me right now when I am a little more tan. I absolutely love this formula. It is sheer but buildable, and after you work that color just a little bit extra than you would a normal one, like you get the perfect amount of color and pigmentation. I love that they are sheer because I don't want to have to work so hard on erasing something. I'd rather work just a tiny bit more on building up a color. So I absolutely love this color. I think this shade here can work for very dark girls and with a lighter hand, more medium fair girls as well. Because of how sheer it is, you can definitely manipulate it a little bit more. This is called Rose Latte and I'm absolutely obsessed with this. So next is another face product, and I'm sorry for the state of this product, but this just attests to like my favorite, that it being my favorite. So this is the MAC Contour Pro Face Palette Contour, and can you tell it's my favorite? This color here, I have a brand new one, I just can't find it. This color here is like a very cool tone contour shade, and this works so beautifully for fair skin, for medium skin, and for medium to tan skin. And then for my more darker girls, this color here as a contour color is absolutely stunning. Like I have this in my kit for my for when I do freelance, but I also use this personally. And then this bronzer, cream bronzer here, is my favorite cream bronzer of all time. But it is not super, super orange and warm, but it's not cool tone at all. It's like a perfect middle ground, and it works on so many different skin tones, this one as well. I think this palette is super, super versatile. And again, it is a little more on that sheer side, so it allows me to build it up. It does not set into a matte. It actually does stay a little more like creamy satin, but I'm totally okay with that because it sits so well on top of my foundation and it doesn't go anywhere. Like if you are a makeup artist that does a lot of freelance, I definitely recommend this cream contour kit. It is amazing, and I think it's like $34 or $40. So it's freaking amazing. MAC, you did your shit with this. I also love the blush palette from the cream blush palette from them as well. So I would definitely recommend this. I absolutely am in love with this palette. All right, so we have one, two, three more, four more items, and then I will let y'all go. I know I talk a lot. So my next item, and I think it's my last makeup item, is the Fenty Pro Filter Powder. Like I said a million times, this is a color that's way too dark for me in like my 90% of my like year, because Chicago is nothing but fall and winter. But in the summer, which this is the first summer that I actually was able to use it, this is a perfect shade for me. This is in the shade Honey, and it's the powder that I have on my face today, and it is absolutely beautiful. Like this blurs my pores like no other powder that I've used, except for the Maybelline Fit Me. It's definitely more affordable, but this is such a gorgeous consistency. It's super fine. It's really, really buttery, and it's not too mattifying. It definitely is matte, but it doesn't make my skin look like crusted and busted and like cracked after I applied it. And then when I spray just some Fix Plus on top of it, it is absolutely beautiful. So if you haven't tried this, I definitely recommend it. And I do believe she has mini versions of this. I could be lying, but if she does, I would definitely either go to Sephora and get a sample, because they do, oh fuck, coronavirus, they're not doing samples right now. Well, if they have a mini version, I would definitely check it out and try it, because it's such a good powder. I am not a powder person at all. I barely started using powder all over my face this year because I film at night, there's a fucking Honda. I film in the middle of the night, there's a fucking Honda. I film at 4 o'clock in the afternoon and there's a fucking Honda. Like, what is wrong with y'all? It's not that deep. You are not in Fast and the Furious. Anyways, what was I saying? Oh, my skin has always been so dry that I never used to put powder all over my face, because I love that like dewy, like greasy, just ate Popeye's chicken look. But as the problem with my pores have like progressed, I realized that the only thing that is gonna help with that is powder. So this is definitely one of my go-to powders now. I just really need to get a shade for my winter shade, because this I use as a bronzer in the winter. That's how dark it is. But okay, so next, it is kind of a body, not sponsored, but she just made my top list this month. This is the Fenty Body Lava. I think I had this in my last favorites, so I'm not gonna go into it, but this is definitely still my favorite. And now that I have like a pool and I've been tanning more, this is just perfect. It's beautiful. Makes me look like a greased rotisserie chicken, and I fucking love it. Like, I'm not gonna go into it. It smells amazing. It's so freaking like worth the price, I think. I know it's outrageous, but I can't see myself going through this anytime soon. And I got a big body. I got a lot of body. So if I can stretch this out for at least 2 summers, you can too. Trust me, you can too. So my second to last product is going to be this dry shampoo by Tresemme between washes. And this is volumizing. I love this shit. The spray is nice. It doesn't leave a white cast in my hair, because my roots are pretty dark right now. This is my natural shade, and don't come for my hair, please. Don't do it. Anyways, this gives me so much volume. I just flip my hair over and spray this into the roots, and it refreshes my hair, and it also just gives me like second day like curls. You know when you like curl your hair and then the next day you get that beautiful like volume and body and like kind of almost like frizziness because you've like worn it up and like slept in it? That's what this gives me, and I am absolutely obsessed. Trust me, isn't the best for your hair, like, let's be real, but when you're balling on a budget, this is definitely one that I recommend. I really, really like this. So many people have recommended the Not Your Mother's and stuff like that, and that one just doesn't do enough for me. Like, it just doesn't work for me, you know. And yeah, I have found that this works for me, and I've tried almost every freaking dry shampoo in the drugstore. Trust me. There is one that I like higher end, but this one, again, because I'm balling on a budget, this one definitely like does what I need it to do. It cleans and it gives me some volume. So that is that. And the last item for today, I don't remember if I talked about this in my last favorites video, but this is the Glam Glow Berry Glow Probiotic Recovery Mask. And this is the shit. So it kind of looks like yogurt, which makes sense because it's like probiotic. It's super thin, but every time I use this, my skin looks beautiful. Like, it, okay, let's see what it's supposed to do. Leave on for 10 minutes. The best results tissue off. Okay, so it doesn't say anything. I don't actually know what it claims to do. All I know is I do think that there's like some like exfoliating aspect to it, very slightly. But I do know is that after, if my skin is looking like dull, if it's looking like, you need to get some rest, sweetheart. You need to sleep. Or like my skin tone is looking a little uneven, or my face is just looking like, you know, like blah. I put this on and my skin is glowing the next few days. Like, it is such a beautiful mask. And I do think like it detoxes, and you know, berries have a lot of antioxidants, so it's just like a, like exactly what it says, it's like a recovery. Like your skin just went through like intensive like facial therapy or something. It makes my skin look even like brighter, and it's such a gorgeous mask. Glam Glow has always made some of my favorite masks throughout my makeup career. I absolutely love this, and I've had this for like 3 months now, and I'm only like halfway, and I use this at least once a week. So yeah, absolutely recommend this. So good job, Glam Glow. Good job. All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching. If you made it this far with me, those are my favorites and all the things that I've been loving in the month of July. If you, please let me know your favorites. I'm always open to like buying makeup. I have an addiction, and I'm trying new things out. I'm obsessed with all things makeup, all things skincare. So please let me know your favorites and something that you recommend. I'll definitely check it out. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to spread love and light. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Bar.